When I started DJing a long, long time ago, I had an all-in-one console, belt drive turntables, and I used to look at DJs who had Technics and think, it just wonder in awe what it would be like. But I got there in the end because I was able to buy a set, saved up, bought a set. Had those for ages, all the way through the 80s, early 90s. And then I remember looking at some strange object, thinking, oh my god, people are playing CDs in a square box that's flat, and you can change the speed, and I was like, amazed! And they were Pioneer CD players. And I've got a set, I've got two of the, I believe they are the some of the original players from back in the day. Now, again, being slightly ignorant here, I don't know if they were the exact originals. I mean, these are the Mark IIs, so there probably was a Mark I, and I believe also there was a CDJ 300 as well. But check this out. Look at this. Now, that is technology, big style from the 90s. This is the Pioneer. It was known then, no longer. It's, of course, now it's Pioneer DJ, but back in the day, Pioneer CDJ 500 Mark II Limited Professional. Now, I have been told that, I also have the, hold on, what's this one here? This one here is just the CDJ 500 Professional, but that one was the Limited, and I've been told that it just had, I think it's like a better memory in it, so anti-shock and something like that. But that's as far as I know. But it does need a bit of a clean. But there it is. Now, this, okay, it works. It's testament to how rock solid these players are. Because this is very old. I don't know the exact amount of years, but it's well over 20 years old, if not 25 years old. So it's still going. Right, so on here, the Nexus Mark II, I have a loop. It's just so we don't get any trouble from the YouTube police. Slow it down, speed it up. Okay, so of course now with the Nexus, you load the CDs in from the front of the player, so I'm going to eject that. Whereas the old school CDJ 500 Mark II, eject, and that pops up. So you put the CD in there, and let's press play. A loop, not the best of loops. Let's go to, I think we had track 3, so press play. That's not too bad, actually. Slow the loop down. Jog wheel, move it anti-clockwise. Speed it up. Moving it clockwise. Now, we have master tempo here as well, so what we can do... I don't know if you can hear that. Okay, again, I don't want to use any music just in case we have copyright issues, but even with the beat, you can hear, without the master tempo engaged, we are having a key change. Listen. Plus or minus 10%. Okay, put master tempo on now, listen. Now, I have to admit, there is a kind of a slight digital sound there, but again, this is old technology. Nowadays, you get that. You don't get it at all. And we have time mode, so we can do count up, count down. Also got a reloop button here. Track search. So track 1, 2, 3, 4, and then search through the track. And that was sort of pretty much it. That was practically it. But back in the day, I mean, you know, if you had a set of these, you were like a god. You were like someone who was amazing. These are just, they are amazing. Now, again, I put something on Facebook about these, and this is my analogy. It's very simple. Back in the day in the UK, you know, if you started learning to drive in the 80s and 70s, you probably had a Ford something, Cortina, Escort, and so on, a Capri. And slowly over time, it ended up being a rust bucket, and you thought, do you know what? I don't really want to spend £500 welding it all together when it's only going to be worth £500. But you see, a lot of us now, including me, are like kicking ourselves because cars like that now are worth an absolute fortune. Now, I don't know the exact model. Hopefully you can help me here. But there was the a Ford Escort turbo something or other, big fin at the back, huge massive fin at the back. And they're going in auctions now, good quality ones, for like nearly £100,000. My God, £100,000. I know one went for about £80,000. It's insane. Now this here, this player, all right? I'm not sure, I need to check. Of course you can do some research on Google if you want to online, but I'm not sure the exact price of these when they were new. But what I honestly think is that they will hold a certain price so long as they're working. And I don't think they're going to go up in price, but this is a bit of history here. This is DJing history. And I am honoured and I am so proud to have a couple of these. And I'm going to be using them, okay? Now, we don't have vinyl mode or any flashy buttons or, you know, any effects or hot cues or, you know, anything like that. But what we do have is something rock solid that can play CDs. And testament to the fact that this, the age of it, and it still works, all right? I'm chuffed about that. Practice and enjoy. Thank you.